So I was actually out in Ecuador in February of 2018 attempting Cotopaxi. Unfortunately, my climbing partner and I, we made it to the traverse, right about 18,500, and had to turn around. So it means a lot for me to be out here again. Obviously a reattempt or redemption, if you will, but this trip, it means far more to me than my last attempt. To be out here with Romp and to be out here with other adaptive climbers, it's just super inspiring and motivating. And it's really special to me too, because being hurt the way that I was, I don't know a ton of female amputees. I don't know a ton of just injured women, period. So it was just powerful for me to see like their recovery and what they've been through and where they're going now. Over the course of a couple of days, you know, we're sharing our tips and tricks, sharing, you know, dreams, goals, life advice, and the whole nine. So, you know, instead of coming out here and, you know, wanting to be the first to the top, like, we're building each other up to be able to stand on top of Cotopaxi together.
Cuando cursaba el segundo semestre de la universidad, en el 2011, tuve un accidente y perdí una extremidad. Fueron meses difíciles, pues tuve que tener toda la disciplina para hacer la terapia física y para entrenarme para volver a caminar con una prótesis. Tuve también el apoyo de mis maestros, de mis amigos, de mi familia, que fueron parte importante en mi recuperación. En 2018 tuve la oportunidad de conocer a Romp en un evento de Estados Unidos de la Amputee Coalition of America. También supe que iban a lanzar próximamente su convocatoria para organizar la quinta escalada con causa. Fue entonces que nació mi deseo de sumarme a este movimiento global y de entrenarme durante los próximos meses para poder ser parte de esta experiencia.
What we do through climbing is show people that disability from amputation can have a completely different face, and that we really are just trying to empower anyone that comes in contact with our organization. And so our service to our patients in the communities where we work and where we live, this is the message that we want to transmit. And one of the best ways of doing that is through example. You know, there's only so much I could say or any one of us can say, but watching someone like Estefania say months ago, yes, I'm fighting for amputee rights in Mexico, and I want to go after this huge challenge in my personal life to show the world that what I'm doing is worth it, that this has value and this is needed. And through example, speaks much louder than any words we could ever say.
This is the fifth year leading my guiding group for this amazing climb to the glaciers of Ecuador. This is going to be like the second time for Cotopaxi. I'm just so privileged and so honored to be part of this amazing experience, to learn from each one, because everyone has an amazing story to tell.
So this year was interesting. There was some weather, some flight delays, some bags lost. I love planning trips. This is the best part of my job, is the climbing for Romp trip every year with the elite team. And you can plan as much as you want, but there are things out of your control.
If it was going to go smoothly, then I mean, it wouldn't be mountaineering. It wouldn't be an expedition.
They got there Saturday night. We went straight into our climb on Pichincha on Sunday. A very difficult climb. Most of us made the summit.
We had a real solid crew of some incredible women on the team this year.
One individual in particular, Estefania, she demonstrated the strength she has and the grit she has on the two climbs for training.
Coming down, I ran into Estefania, who was really struggling with the scree part of the climb. With the time of everything, the guide suggested that she turn around at some point.
Her pace, she just could not keep up with everyone. Now, I was noticing some struggles in the way she was moving. She was not fully taking advantage of her prosthetic knee technology, and just wondering, what can we do in these next few days to help unlock more of her mobility and potential on the mountain? She has an incredible amount of courage and heart, and so that was evident that she had the capacity within her to reach the summit that we were aiming for at the end of the week, but she needed a lot of help along the way. So what we did back in the lodge was I did some alignment adjustments to kind of maximize the efficiency of her motion. Kirsty was helping her to feel the movements and learn how to ride the knee down step over step, over and over in the lodge, down the stairs, then outside, in the grass, on the ramp. And watching her click with that, and some of just the offhanded comments that she made as that was happening, you know, like, que rico, que delicia, you know, she was feeling all of a sudden this new movement in her body, this new capability.
She's actually using the same knee that I'm using. And to know that I was just in her shoes literally a year ago trying to figure out this new knee, trying to figure out the mountains. Right. What I've been doing for the past few years is about paying it forward. So to me now to be able to do this for her, like I couldn't help but be proud. You know, I sat there and I cried when she like figured out how to go down the steps.
Yeah, girl.
También tuve la inspiración de una maravillosa mujer, Kirsty Ennis. Pues ambas somos usuarias de prótesis por arriba de rodilla y esto de alguna manera hizo que nuestras almas, nuestro corazón, nuestras experiencias como mujeres amputadas se conectaran. Conocerla fue una gran inspiración, fue un gran regalo, pues es una mujer dedicada al servicio de los demás.
This whole life is just about leaving a legacy. You know, if you don't share your stories or you don't share your experience or help the next guys and gals, then I mean, you're just gonna take it with you.
I think Kirsty was really proud of Estefania in that moment, watching kind of their friendship form and flourish. Baby bird. Fly out of the nest, baby bird. Going into Rumanyawi the next day, I think she was still tired but felt really excited to kind of use these skills that she had learned in the lodge that night on an actual mountain. She again didn't make it to the summit there, but it wasn't because we had to turn her around for any reason or her own ability. So we all made it to the summit. She was pretty close, and these clouds came in, and we had to move super fast down. We had to hike down this ridge. There was no coverage, and it was full-on hail and lightning storm. I just get chills thinking about it because I didn't want to be anywhere near there. Looking around, there was nowhere else to go.
Yeah, just hoping everyone makes it down safe at this point.
That type of weather change is what really keeps us prepared, especially for moving forward to Cotopaxi, where the weather can change at any moment.
And I have to emphasize how difficult this trip is physically. Going into it and doing two training climbs over 15,000 feet, it takes a lot of physical strength. And the team this year had trained really hard, Estefania included. And it showed, it really showed.
No completar ninguno de los dos primeros ascensos de aclimatación no me desmotivó, pues sabía cuál era el propósito de este viaje, hacer cima en el volcán Cotopaxi y demostrar al mundo que con la tecnología protésica adecuada, ninguna montaña es demasiado alta. No es el tiempo ni la velocidad el que importa para alcanzar la cima, sino más bien tener un paso firme y un corazón alegre.
This is going to be the second night of the refuge. They did today this first glacier practices. So everything is kind of settled for tonight. It looks like it's going to be perfect for tonight. I think everyone is a little bit anxious. Everyone is a little bit nervous. I'm really looking forward that they have an amazing time with Summit or without Summit, just experience to be here. They are all heroes for me.
So when we were at the refuge and getting ready to do our ascent of Cotopaxi, had dinner, we had some really awesome engagement by the local community, and I was just pretty numb to all of it, kind of blank, until I crawled into my sleeping bag. And that's when my mind was just flooded with everything. I think nerves kind of kicked in, like what if I didn't summit again? Would I be able to move quickly through the glacier, through that little loose terrain area? And then of course that traverse. The traverse is where I got turned around last time. There was a bunch of emotions in the couple of hours leading up to, you know, actually it being go time. And so we actually had a Stephania that left at 9:30.
She left the earliest out of everybody. And Cumbre Tours, Carl was really, you know, hoping that she would have enough time to get up there.
With that strategy that we would all kind of reach the summit around the same time.
I'm feeling the mountain.
She has had tough moments in life. She had a beautiful desire to be once back in a mountain. For her, it was the first experience ever to be in a glacier.
You're amazing, guys, you got it!
Truly, you do not need more than what your headlamp offers. And as an amputee, I'm very focused on the one step in front of me. So to not get the bigger picture of what's to come, it actually, to me, keeps me focused. And if you've never seen headlamps making their way up a mountainside, it's like, gosh, there they go, and I'm gonna get there. And then the next step is I'm gonna get there. And so we all look like just stars in the sky.
Tenía al mejor guía, a Paul, que en todo momento confió en mí y me motivó y me alentó para seguir en este camino. Poco a poco veía cómo mis compañeros avanzaban y que la noche iba transcurriendo. Al pasar las horas y ver que empezaba a amanecer, mi cuerpo empezaba a sentirse cansado.
I remember passing Estefania right at the toe of the glacier, which is about a third of the way up Cotopaxi. And it just felt in my mind, we passed her too soon. I wanted to see her further up on the mountain when we got to her. And in that moment, I turned to Dave and I was like, I don't think she's gonna make it. And Dave agreed that, you know, with the time we had, that it might not happen this year for her.
Again, there's a lot of reflecting and a lot of just looking at where I've been and where, you know, obviously being on Cotopaxi, like everything that's like led me up to that point. So I was already fairly emotional, and then taking that, you know, next 10 steps onto the summit and being greeted by just, you know, all of the fellow romp crew and amputees, supporters, staff, volunteers, the whole nine, like it was just an overwhelming feeling. You know, I've been to some of the most amazing mountains in the world, and this one meant the most to me, just because of who was here. So my initial reaction to seeing Estefania heading up on my way down, at first I was really concerned because it was getting pretty hot, and I know she doesn't have that much experience, like technically on a mountain, so if something did happen, crevasses start to open up, whatever, I started to worry about that.
Estaba cansada, aunque mi corazón tenía muy claro por qué estaba en esa expedición. Fue entonces que decidí continuar. Decidí continuar con la voluntad de mi corazón y de mi mente. Un paso a la vez.
Mobility for all.
That's right.
That's your mountain. This is mine.
She was not far behind, making her way up the mountain with her guide, with that same smile on her face. And, God. And, you know, all the odds could be against her. Remove everything physicality about her, like what she's done to train. It is 100% between her head and her heart of what she just did.
Estaba realmente entusiasmada, pues solo faltaban unos cuantos metros. Y entonces, de pronto, llegué a la cima. Qué gran regalo poder ver la naturaleza a esa altitud, poder sentir el latir de mi corazón y poderme entusiasmar por declararle al mundo y a las personas que me han acompañado durante estos años de mi vida, por lograr esta meta. Esta meta es de todos ellos. Esta meta es por todas las personas que han perdido una extremidad, para que tengan esa inspiración, para que tengan esa confianza y que se sepan capaces de crear cualquier cosa que deseen en su vida. Yo creo que cada persona tiene su propia montaña. Lo importante es la actitud y las personas que te acompañan para escalar esa montaña, para llegar a tu cima.
Cotopaxi es this symbol for what's possible when you have access to the right tools, just like the tools that we're using on the mountain. Those are a symbol too for what we might need in our daily life. So a prosthetic leg is a tool, a symbol for mobility and freedom, just as an ice axe and crampons are symbols and necessary to reach the summit. And you can't do it without those. It really does relate to everyone and the human spirit and what we're all going through.
I have no idea like what that has done for her personally, but I think about like my first big summit and what that did for me and just the confidence in my prosthetic. Possibilities are endless now, you know, whether that's physically or mentally and emotionally, because mountaineering is far more than just, you know, what our bodies are capable of. You know, it's a lot of head and heart.
And it's always one of those things, which way are you gonna go when you're standing in this kind of decision making? Am I gonna pick this route and climb mountains, or am I gonna stay on the sidelines? And Estefania is not a person who is ever gonna sit on the sidelines. And she is gonna be forever climbing mountains from this day forward.